Okay. I don't know if this old pen is gonna last long enough. Huh. What's going on, Goose Hunter? Yeah, I know, it's been a while. I've just been really busy, you know, getting stuff done and, you know, within my real life and everything, so. And it just so happens that my drawing has, and my illustration dreams have been kind of taken off. So I'm making the best of it. So today I'm just going to be cross-hatching a self-portrait of me. This is just a cross-hatch drawing that I did the other day, so just to kind of cover it until I have something else here. So, good. We'll start something. Let me get all prepared. This really isn't the most comfortable seating arrangement, so let's see. I'm gonna pull up a picture of myself. Okay. Oh yeah, I know, I've seen you here many times. Okay, so I'm gonna give this a shot. I don't know if I wanna use this old boy. This thing is, these Micron pens, I love them, but I don't know if it's gonna hold out long enough. So we'll kind of take a look at this every so often and see if I want to hold on to it or not. I'm trying a couple different styles of cross-hatching. So yeah, I'll be checking the chat every once in a while. My true identity is yet to be revealed. You might not recognize me. Truth that the goose has been here but a few occasions. I've seen you here before. But maybe you got something to tell me that I don't know about. Or maybe you don't have anything to tell me and you're just trying to give me the creepers. Either way, I don't know. So, I don't have any guidelines here, so this is kind of just... I don't really know if this is like the number one way to crosshatch an entire drawing. Personally, if it were up to me, which it's not, this is just purely based on what my professor wanted me to do. I probably would have gone with more of like a lines that include a little bit of crosshatching for the shading rather than the entire thing shaded, just for good measure, but it's okay. My job as an artist is to try and do everything to the best of my abilities, whether or not I'm any good at it. Why is there an ant? I'm just going through with a nice light crosshatch first. You were right about the first one. Might be back soon if this hotel is Wi-Fi. Oh, yeah. You must not have school tomorrow, do you? I do at 8:30. Or maybe I don't. Who knows? I guess we'll find out when I show up. I don't want to smear anything, so... Okay. Let's see. So all the mistakes that happen, I'm just gonna have to simply refurbish those with, you know, editing through adding unnecessary lines. So because like I said, I have no sense of direction right now. It's whatever I can do. So for the eye, I think I'm gonna put a light. A light guideline. Kind of stipple some of the rounds rather than crosshatch. Now I understand my eyes are a little bit more round than that. Therefore, this may entail a little bit of an issue. Yeah, right now it's just about what can I do to maintain the personability of the drawing. You know, I don't wanna send this down Schitt's Creek and then end up, you know, not being looking like me at all. What? What's up, Goose? Okay, now the moment of truth. Can I get the eyes to look the same? This is gonna have to take a second of preparation. Lightning Striker ring a bell? Ah, yes, Lightning Striker. Of course I know Lightning Striker. He's like one of my oldest oldest viewers. The eyes can be fixed after. I'm not too worried about that. So a lot of what this is just, you know, trying to do my best to go off of the style that is presented here. Like I said, I'm doing my own real thing. I have no clue what's actually going on within this. Ah, Goose, you are Lightning Striker? What is going on, dude? Long time no see. Okay, so now to add some of the construction lines here. Yeah, I mean, basically going from, drawing to Pokemon, I mean, from streaming Pokemon to drawing, I mean, it's a full 180, so, you know, I mean, this is what we got now, an empty chat room most of the time, except during earlier afternoons, so, you know, sometimes you give up what works to pursue your dream, and, it's working better in real life than, but I'm a lot more active in real life than I am on stream, so things are a little bit different. One second. Alright, let's see what this says. So far nothing crazy out of this. Saw, dude, what's going on? Quite sad, but I'm still here, aren't I? Yeah.
Hi.
Hey. No, I wouldn't call it sad. I mean, I always appreciate it when I have somebody to just hang out for a little while. You know, I mean, I don't provide these streams as much entertainment. I know that. I mean, like, this stream has a tendency to get boring fairly easy now, because it's just drawing. I think the difference between this stream and what is, like, what I want everybody to get out of the stream more than, you know, watching it and being, you know, focused the entire time. I just want people to, you know, open up their own sketchbook and kind of enjoy drawing that way. You know, things like that. You know, this is something that I would like to just, you know, have my streams on in the background while you do stuff or, you know, whatever. I may have made my brow too dark. Guess we'll see once it's done. It's going pretty good. How are you? As you can see from the title, it's a cross-hatching self-portrait. I'm doing my best to do it without any guidelines, and it's rough. You have crippling depression. How? Dude, you're like no older than 13. You shouldn't have crippling depression by now. That is really bad. I don't, you know, I mean, you know, if life, you know, I understand, you know, I mean, especially in middle school was never a, an easy time for me. So, I understand that life sucks, but I wouldn't go so far as to say you have depression. Only because depression is something you can't get out of, and, you know, nothing makes you feel good, I guess. I don't know. I refuse to believe that I've ever had it, so... because I'm much more fortunate than, and the majority of people that I've been around. So, you know what? If I have crippling depression, what does that mean for everyone else?
Sweetheart.
Night.
Where's your keys?
Good question. They're probably in the living room. Alright, well, 15, man. Still. Too young. Too young to be complaining right now. You're good? That's good. Should be, man. It's Thursday night. It's pretty close to Friday. Do I wear my headset on backwards? Maybe. Who cares? I don't use the, mic anyways. I have my, my thing. Let's see. Is it all backwards? Yeah, guess so. It's always been like this. It keeps the cord from getting, because I'm a left-handy. So. Oh, it's Friday morning for you? Ah, happy Friday morning. Alright, let's keep this ball rolling here. I'm probably going to upload this to YouTube. I hope there's no copyright issues with this. Somebody told me this was copyright free, but can you really trust people nowadays? I don't know. Guess we'll have to find out. See if I can get this other eye here. Wait, hold on. see how this looks. Could be better, but we're not really complaining. 246. Oh, you must not have anything to do tomorrow morning. Otherwise, if you do, man, time to get some sleep. Who needs sleep? Yeah, you got me there. That is a good question. Especially, you know, due to the fact that simply I gotta be up at 7 in the morning. I'm probably gonna be messing with this crap till 1 or 2. So, because who needs sleep? I believe Confucius once said, sleep is for the weak. I don't think he said that at all, but. So this eye is definitely off. My question is, how am I gonna fix it? Because this is pretty good. Not so good. I'm gonna have to do something. All right, let's pull something out of my ass here and those are definitely two different eyes. Let me see this. My only choice here is to risk working on, risk enhancing both eyes and seeing what happens. So even though I liked the other one, and the other one turned out decent, there's no way, and there's no going back. I'm so sorry, poor eyes. I'm gonna have to make you look like I am in the band The Killers. What are you doing, bro? You're on camera.
Yeah, no, I was just flexing in the camera, bro.
Yeah, can you not?
I just did.
Does everybody in this family have to fucking walk in and, like, have some cameo on the camera? I'm getting up so early because I got school, so. You think I have a concussion? You think you have a concussion? What's that? Or, like, how do you figure that? I'm just gonna start locking my door from now on when I stream. No more people are allowed in. Oh, I love the pen that you were using. Oh, yeah, I know. The Microns, I hate using them because they're just so good and they dry out so quickly. But I hate buying new ones because they're so expensive, but I love these pens, man. These pens are beautiful. They create such nice pictures, so. I'll add the texture to that, so it might look weird now, but trust me, there'll be texture. I got a cut on my hand, it's really starting to burn. Sorry for me going so quiet all of a sudden. It's mostly just trying to concentrate and trying to chill. Like I said, this is just a stream to kind of leave on in the background when you're doing something cool or whatever. You know, I mean, especially right now when there's not many people in the stream, it's not imperative for me to go crazy. You know, I mean, I might be losing out on some potential conversations with people that stop by and they're like, dude, this guy is not talking at all. I'm out of here. But, to me, it's okay. It's A-okay. So this side is a bit more shaded off than the other one anyways, so. So this is going to be a challenging part, trying to get the hair right. Oh, certainly. But one step at a time. That's all you can really do. Alright, so far, I mean, I really have to get the texture right with the hair, if anything, if I'm going to continue on, mostly because this cross-hatching is giving my hand a workout. But we carry on. We carry on. I mean, I enjoyed this. This is really, it's peaceful. The music is awesome. I'm really glad I found this music. I'm gonna post this whole stream probably on YouTube just for fun. You know, might get some good out of it. You know, I don't expect many views or anything. My current YouTube channel, it's not really built for viewership yet, so not even worried about that right now. I mean, I haven't done any ridiculous amounts of advertising myself anywhere, so you know, I'd be foolish to think that I can get any real views. I mean, my other YouTube channel found some success, to the point where I could easily get 40 to 50 views per video, as well as ranging up to, like, you know, easily a couple of my videos got a couple thousand views. So I mean, it was nice, but you know, nothing comes without hard work, and especially not YouTube, when everything is so accessible and people are just better than they were 10 years ago or even 5 years ago. You know, 5 years ago, you upload a video and it gets 100 views, and hey, not bad, you know? Now it's more along the lines of, you know, upload a video and your first couple are going to get 2 views, 1 view, 0. And you just gotta respect that. And then you get, you know, 10,000 views and you're still not really anything popular. You're just another YouTuber with a video that got a lot of views. And, you know, a lot is not even a guaranteed term anymore for that. I think 10,000 is pretty good. You know, it's, for the average Joe, it's pretty good. For somebody who's seriously doing stuff, I don't know. So at this point, I've pretty much given up, or, you know, not given up, but left behind my reference altogether. Once I get the majority of the features down, I kind of leave the reference behind and just go from there. And, you know, I know you should be paying attention to what you're drawing on a pretty heavy basis, but you know, and you should keep it all relatively accurate, but I believe things like hair, the harder you try and make them accurate to the picture, the more, you know, stale they're gonna look. So I don't really have a set way to draw hair. It always really changes, always has, and may very well always will. Let's see here. Okay, so now we can kind of get into some more details. Like I said, the hair is really just hit or miss. You know, it's not something that I pride my work on. You know, I mean, it's not something that I would say is one of my better abilities to make very, very intricate, you know, hair texture. You know, that's the reason I probably won't find myself in a career of rendering video game hair or anything like that, because God bless those people. I wouldn't have the patience for that. I mean, the majority of my work is really just really loose-based, stagnant stuff. You know, I love to make stuff in motion, but, when it comes down to something like this, I think this is a comfortable thing. You know, a lot of times it's nice to just go off and create my own, image and my own, you know, scenario or character without any, requirements, because then if it doesn't turn out how I expected, it still looks kind of cool. But a self-portrait like this, especially one that's going to be, graded for a specific purpose, per my instructor's discretion, you know, things like this are really just, it's crucial to get it right the first time. I'm gonna check something out here. Don't have fears. All right. I want to refresh my stream real quick. I started off, with about, I've gained about 9 people. It's not terribly good, but it's not bad either. Just keep on keeping on. You know, I'm probably just gonna be talking to myself for a while, you know, just to keep the old juices flowing, and you know, who knows, somebody might stumble by saying, hey, this guy's drawn and talking, and you know, and just might get a little bit of a reaction out of some people. I mean, I could draw in silence all night, trust me. But I kind of want to keep people entertained. You know, gaining an audience would be nice. Especially due to the fact that I don't have one right now. You know, sometimes I have some people, but rarely are they here to watch me draw. It's more about the communication, so. But I guess that's what it is for all streamers, so. I guess I'll just keep it pretty. I'll keep it pretty talkative. As much as I can, anyways. A lot of times I go into a full on, like, just like AWOL in terms of my communicating. And that's just simply out of the fact that, like, I don't know. Like I said, I can keep it pretty quiet here if I wanted to. Especially when I'm drawing, you know, I mean, a lot of concentration is required for, you know, certain things, especially when you're not comfortable with drawing a certain thing. It can become very, very tough to try and continue talking to myself, let alone other people. So, I mean, I have to find a balance for it, but, you know, it's not the end of the world. Let's see here. I want to get pretty dark up in here. I don't know how dark I can get, but this whole region back here from the reference I'm using is it's pretty dark, so it's not the whole thing, but you know, a good portion of it. This pen's probably gonna have to say goodbye by the time I'm done though. Holy crap. Make a significant darker pattern here so it's easy and visibly simple to tell that there's a little bit of highlight but nothing too heavy there. Same thing up here. You know, random highlights are not my best friend, so I'd rather keep the eyes guessing, you know. The longer somebody looks at artwork, the more they appreciate it, so. Let's not make it too easy to watch. Okay, now I'm gonna have to shade here any moment. So if that's going to happen, then I'll have to make sure that no matter what, I do not go overboard. Because if I go overboard, I'm gonna regret it. Let's see. Okay, there's a bit of shade right up in here. You know, I'd love to go in a little bit deeper and try my, go in a little bit deeper. That sounds really, really bad. No, I'd like to try my luck. Kind of doing some of that. I don't know if that's going to be a very good idea though. Because I want to keep it generally simple, and I always end up going overboard and making my drawings maybe not too dark, but overshaded. Overshading is a bad habit of mine, and it's definitely a possibility. Let's see, going back at the, I want to generally keep the face more or less shaded, or unshaded. I don't want to touch too far into it just in case. Yeah, if I'm gonna add a little bit of shading here. Okay, and I can afford to kind of go a little bit darker on the upper lip. Yeah, I don't want to go overboard with it. But, you know, I mean, just a little something here or there. Okay, keep it simple. And then we'll do, you know, I mean, obviously lips are not the same color as your skin. So, I'll do a little bit of cell shading there, just to natural it out a bit. These top lips, or the top lip needs to be a bit darker. Okay. You know what? Before I go too crazy with it, just make sure that it looks natural. That's all I need. I've got a little bit of definition on this side where the cheekbone is, so let's add a little bit over here. Plus maybe some shadows. And the more I do this, the more I feel like the top lip just needs to be much darker altogether. Okay, and the next thing I see that should be done is probably the neck. Okay, so, you know, for this part, it's, you know, luckily I can't really go too overboard with the neck. It's going to be really difficult to overshadow that, although it is possible, so I wouldn't, you know, just go pitch black on it, unless I want to look like, Tyler from, 21 Pilots, so. Maybe we won't do that today. Or tonight. It's almost 11, isn't it? I can tell because my voice is starting to get a little raspy. I'm becoming what most human mortals would call tired. I mean, I'm not there yet, but... Let's see. Ah, yeah, we can do this. Kind of overshade that all the way, anyways. You know, my lips are pretty dark in this. That's gonna suck. Thank you. Luckily, I can kind of just, I can make good of the entire drawing just by making a simple, setting for the outfit itself. If I can get away with that, then we're good. I love drawing sweatshirts because they just, or hoodies, because I don't know, they give that extra bit of satisfaction. So plus, they always look like, it's like the perfect clothing to work on if you ever want to learn how to draw wrinkles and just clothing effects in general. Because it's so hard to make a mistake drawing wrinkles on a hoodie, so. I mean, the more wrinkly it gets, the different style of hoodie it is, so. I mean, I'm sure there's a point at which it's too much. There's a point at which everything is too much, but, you know. Hopefully this, you know, doesn't have any atrociously bad effects, and then we'll be good. Okay, so I wanna signify that this isn't just white. And that's mainly my reason for cross-hatching this. You know, this drawing is completely from cross-hatch. Like, from a distance, it doesn't look like that. It looks like I did what I needed to do to draw some lines, but up close, it's crosses and hatches. I do look kind of gothic in it. It's kind of weird. And I don't think I'm getting that out of the lips any. Yeah, the only thing I can do is try to make him a little bit darker. I'm just trying to kind of gauge where I'm at in the drawing and where I need to be. Man, I wouldn't say it doesn't look like me, but I'm going for ultra. Not ultra, but fairly realistic. Because I fear this is far from realistic. Although it's not bad. I'm pretty proud of it. Alright, now I can kind of sharpen this up a bit. Again, I'm a firm believer that there is no such thing as too many wrinkles when it comes to hoodies, but then again, we haven't seen the finished product yet, so I very well could be in for a nice surprise. If I look up and it looks like I'm in an astronaut suit, then we're gonna know. We're definitely gonna know. I'm gonna take a little picture of this real quick. Thank you. So, you know, I mean, at this point, I just have to kind of one-hit wonder the notch. I chose this side as my shaded side. I didn't want to go both sides, out of respect for the image. You know, when you get blessed with a pretty decent face, you don't want to overboard it, because then I look like a skull, you know, and I'm already very critical on my lipstick looking face, and there's not real way to solve that. So, you know, that's something that's just gonna stick on the drawing. Yeah, I see a little bit more detail being added here. Okay, so you know, I mean, at this point, I'm pretty much just finishing up the image at its own pace. I mean, there's a bit of shade involved there. I wouldn't say this is too bad. I just don't like that lipstick look on his lips. Or my lips, I should say. I guess there's a bit more protrusion of shadow around here. It's not much though, so I don't want to go overboard with it. Yeah, the darker I make the outlines of the lips, the better it does not look like lipstick. Perfect. I don't want to go too much crazier on this. I mean, for the most part, I think it's done. I think I have pretty successfully drawn myself in a crosshatch form completely. There's not much else, you know, you can really do here. Oh man, I may have gone a little too dark on that one.
Okay.
Let's see this. Yeah, I don't want to make him too bushy either. I think I'll quit while I'm slightly less behind. Alright, so that's my attempt at a picture or a cross-hatching self-portrait. For the most part, does it look exactly like me? No, but you know, my options are pretty limited when drawing myself, you know, only due to the fact that I'm not used to drawing with pens and things, so trying to limit my color or my, you know, shade revenue is pretty difficult. Cause like from there, you know, I'm pretty good. From here, looks like a woman, you know? Let's see, what can I do to make my eyebrows look more like me? That's super light. It's not Friday, it's Thursday.
It's almost Friday.
Well, alright. Do you have to do this right this second?
No, can you do it after?
No, just leave me alone. I have to be up by 7 in the morning. I'll do it tomorrow. Ugh, great. Great, 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 great. Hey, Beats. This looks pretty sick. The hair. Yes, yes, yes. I am still uploading this on YouTube. Despite everybody in my family needing a freaking cameo. And thank you for the compliment. Sorry, I didn't see what you wrote. I mean, it's gonna be a pretty long video, so I don't expect it to go very far in. It's 2 hours, so, you know, the majority of this is probably just gonna be, you know, it's gonna be uploaded on YouTube, but nothing serious. I don't expect any views, or, you know, a large majority of views out of it. Oh, you did? What have you been uploading? Well, I upload on my new channel. So, Artistic Chris. So you may not be a sub to me. I'm gonna find a decent pen to sign my name with, because my first signature was pretty weak. And then I'm going to say, oh, you're uploading drawings. Sweet. All right, then you gotta definitely tell me what your channel is so I can check it out. I love looking at other, or fellow artists' stuff. Here, I'll give you the, actually I don't have the link on hand right now. It's just Artistic Space K-R-Y-S. Let's see. Is my good marker in here? No. O500. A BR, is this what I need? So that's probably the doofiest thing. Oh yeah, the Sketch Maniac. I will sub to you for sure. Alright, well, that was my hand at drawing myself in total crosshatch. You can see, I'll zoom this in for you. See, everything is crosshatched. See? Every single thing is just little hatches. So up close, it looks like you know, just little lines creating an image, but you move further away. Let's get this right here. And it doesn't, you know, I mean, it's pretty cool. Does it look like me? Not totally, you know. I believe the lips are too dark. Eyebrows are too dark, too heavy. But, what can you do, you know? There's not much of a way to remove some of that. I can't even think of what I could use. I can try my hand at eraser. Now this eraser ain't gonna do nothing. Well, thank you. Yeah, like I said, it took about 2 hours. I'll upload it on YouTube, so But, you know, other than that, I mean, it was fun. It was fun to make something. And, you know, hopefully, it, you know, tomorrow it looks good for everyone. Because this is, you know, for a project in class. So, what I want to do real quick. Oh, please, please don't screw me over here. I'm doing my last minute touches. This is perfect. Usually a pretty bad idea. Alright, and with that being said, I'm gonna stop while I can. I'll add a little bit more hair right there. And yeah, I'm gonna stop while I'm good. It's not perfect, and like I said, the lips, you know, are pretty dark, but that's okay. It's no biggie. So yeah, I'm gonna call this a night. I'm gonna drop the pen. I'm gonna drop the last minute touches. I'm done. Nothing else is. I have to do this. I have to do this. I have to do this. Sorry. Okay, now I'm gonna drop the pen for good. No more. I'm gonna go. See you guys. Thank you for watching. This will be up on YouTube. And we'll just see what comes out of it. I appreciate you watching. Peace out, guys. And look forward to my rebranding on Twitch. I am going to hope to no longer be Suit and Tie Media altogether. Or gamers. I'd like.